first book that was translated. But now sometimes, unconsciously, I try not to think, but I know that the book I'm writing now will probably be translated in at least some, not maybe not all these many countries, but some of them. Does that make me more conscious? No. But then sometimes I write something that I think only Dutch people will understand. Do I change it? No, I don't. So in a way, nothing changes. It's for me, it's a really good feeling that there are so many readers and also so many different readers and so many, I had the same experience as Georgie, many different reactions from many different countries.
So you don't psychoanalyze your future market?
No, I won't.
Okay, because we must go to the presentation. Last words, Herman, what do you want to say to these young people, future editors and translators?
And probably writers.
And probably writers, of course.
Only probably.
I think the most important thing, but probably you will, is enjoy what you're doing. But for me, the most difficult part I found when I was about 18 or 20, I really loved to write. But then I thought, if I turn into a professional, maybe I will see it as a work. So don't. Try to see it as something you want to do.
Съветът е да се забавлявате и да харесвате това, което правите, защото аз си спомням, че още на 18-19 години много обичах да пиша, но си дадох сметка, че ако го избера за професия, ще гледам на това като на труд и на работа. Затова не дейте. По-добре.
Ако аз дам съвет, понеже преподавам, това значи да приключим курса с
така че ти ще го кажеш в последната лекция.
Само на тези, които са идвали на предишните.
Ами, благодаря ви много, че дойдохте. Благодаря на Херман и на Жоро за чудесния разговор. Ако можете, заповядайте и в книжарница Хеликон за представянето. Благодаря ви.
Не важно, не важно.